Okay, this is for a friend of mine who asked a question about substitution code in English. There's 26 letters in the English alphabet. And so if you do a substitution code, you just go to the next letter. So instead of A to Z, you do B to Z, and then you add A at the end. So it's the next character. So when you're writing a message, you add one to the character. Then when you're decoding the message, you subtract one from the character. So for example, if you see, here's the message here, right? So if you see an I, then you go to the next smallest character, which is an H. So if I want to write a message, let me just add a layer here in Photoshop. I'm clicking on the, there, so I have a new layer here, and I'm going to write a test message under here. So if I say, hello world, that's my message. But if I want to put it in code, let me change the color to green. Then I add one to each letter. So for H, I type I. For E, I type F. For L, I type M. M, P for O, and space. So what's the letter after W? It is X. Letter after O is P. S. M. And after D is E. Right? So then you have your coded message. So when you send it, you're sending only the green part, I, F, M, M, P, X, P, S, M, E, right? So that nobody else knows what you're saying. And then if you want to decode it, you have to take one letter off the message, right? So suppose I didn't have that message there. I only had the I, F, M, M, and P, right? And I wanted to know what it said. Then I would come here. Let's use blue. And then I'll type here, but I'll take one letter away. So I, the letter before I is H. The letter before F is E. The letter before M is L. L, the letter before P is O, so it says hello. Then the next word, the letter before X is W. Letter before P is O, letter before S is R. Letter before L is M, and the letter before E is D. So it says hello world. Okay, so that's how it works. So let's do that for the original message. Sorry, I clicked on that by mistake. Let me do a Control Z and a step backward to get rid of that rectangle. So for our original message, let's do the same thing. Take one letter off of each letter, and let's use a different color. Let's use red. So here's our original message. Let's start where the message starts. So the first letter is I. What is the letter before I? H. Capital H. Then the next letter is J. So what is the letter before J? It is I, right? Then there's a comma, that'll be the same. Space. Then the next letter is F. And what is the letter before F? It's E, capital E. And W, you can look at the chart here if you don't know, right? So what is the letter before W? It is V, right? And the next letter is F. What is the letter before F? It is E. And so on, R, E, T, T, and exclamation mark. So it says, hi, Everett, right? Because Everett is the guy's name, the boy's name. Then, okay, then we'll just do the same thing. U, the letter before U is T. So it says, T, H, E, R, E, there, space. B, what's the letter before B? A. R, what's the letter before T? S. O. T. A. S. Space. A. N. D. What's the letter before T? S. S. N. A. Letter before D is C. There are sodas and snacks. Okay, so J O. What is the letter before J? I. What is the letter before O? N. In. So U. What is the letter before U? T. Before I is H. R, E, F, what is the letter before S, R, space, I, I might have left that space by mistake, it's hard to read, right, that's really supposed to be no space there, because I'm up to J there, R, J, S, I, R, that might be a mistake there, H, S, A, T, O, R. That's somehow there's a spelling mistake in there because here in our little picture here it says S F G S J H. Oh, I made a spelling mistake. See that. It says JH there, but I typed JS there. That's why this should be JHF, like that. GPS is the letter before G is H. The letter before, no. The letter before G is F, O, R. And the letter before Z is Y, O, U. And B, O, E is A, N, T, J, J. And E is D. Letter before B is A. Letter before E is, so it says dad, right? Okay, let's fix that spelling mistake in Photoshop here. I'll take my eraser. And I'll erase this part here. Well, that's a brush. Okay, I'll take a rectangle. And I'll draw a rectangle. Oops, sorry, I mean a brush. I'll brush that out. Okay, so let me make a... I have my layer here with my decoding here, so let me make a new layer. That'll be called layer 1, and in that there... layer, let me type in the new, the correct spelling. Let's make that green. Okay, let me just type the correct spelling in there. I made a typing mistake when I was retyping this here, this part here. It is J. So that's the whole answer, and this is PhotoShop, so I'm going to save it as a PSD. I'll save it as a PSD, which is a Photoshop file, and I will also save it as a normal file. So Photoshop is a little bit slow because it's such a big program. Save it as a JPEG. I've already got the JPEG is the original, so let me save it as a GIF. Where's GIF? Flatten layers? Yes. The layers, is something that's used in Photoshop, right? Because if I open my original file, let's open my original file again, which is a 0019.psd. Here it is, then it has all the layers, right? So in Photoshop, I can turn layers off and on. So if I don't want to see the answer, I can turn off the answer layer, right? If I don't want to turn off, if I want to turn off the correction, I can turn off the correction there. Right. This is a garbage layer, I think. This is the part where I have the hello world. This is the part where I have the coding. That's the part where I put in the alphabet. And this is the original message. So that's answer to the question about the decoding. And thanks for watching.